Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel VBA Chapter 17, Tint and Shade. Okay, so Chapter 17 is all about sparklines. Why am I not doing sparklines in the podcast? Because I love when I discover something new and cool. And I was looking at colors. You know, we always used to use, color index back in Excel 2003 from 1 to 56, or, RGB. You know, but now the macro recorder starts doing this, the theme color. All right, you know, and the themes, I get it. Page layout, you can choose a theme, and each theme has six colors. All right, you can see how the colors change back there. All right, and we can even define a new theme. You know, each theme is comprised of six accent colors, and then we see these a lot back on the home tab, and either the font color or the fill color, the six accent colors appear here. But what's interesting is this lighter 80%, lighter 60%, lighter 40%, darker 25%, darker 50%. So, you know, think about it. Those six accent colors are shown with five different variations there. Now, I love when I discover the VBA does something better than the Excel interface does, and that was exactly what happened here, because when I actually looked at this code, we have theme color, Excel theme color accent 1 through 6, those are the 6 for the theme, but then Tint and Shade turns out that it can be a number anywhere from negative 0.99 all the way up to positive 0.99. The negative numbers are darker, the lighter numbers are the positive numbers are lighter. And so I actually wrote a little macro here that went through and looked at the 100 different darker values. So this is the orange that is our theme color 6, but it goes all the way down to black depending on what tint and shade we use. And I'll scroll down here. Here's another little macro I wrote that came up with the 99 lighter colors. All right, so that one orange color goes from completely black to completely white in 200 different steps. All right, so using Tint and Shade to modify the theme accent color, you're not limited to just those five that they happen to give us. Use, again, positive and negative numbers here. Let's just try it. We'll choose a cell over here now. In this case, theme accent color 1 is blue, so we'll just use a tint and shade of 0 first to see how that looks. We'll run that code, and you see we get that blue. All right, but then if we would use a tint and shade, let's go darker, so minus 0.75. Run that. All right, so that's almost black, almost too dark. So how about minus 0.5? Run that one. Okay, so you can start to see that actually is blue. And then if we go positive, those start to go lighter instead of darker. All right, so a whole bunch of different colors you can use. And the advantage to using the theme colors rather than RGB is that as you change the theme back here on the page layout, so we'll just choose another random theme, those colors automatically change, so it picks up the different colors in the theme. Very slick. I think it's cool that we have many more options than what they give us here back in the home tab of the ribbon. So, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.